Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15 RC. This is available to developers and hopefully soon to public beta testers. This is the final version of iOS 15, and RC means release candidate, or basically the same as the GM or Golden Master that they used to call it. It's the exact same thing. Now that means that this version, if they don't find any additional issues in it, will be released to the public when it comes out for everyone, and that will be on September 20th. Apple announced after the iPhone 13 event today that it will be out on the 20th, which is a Monday. So it will be out in just a little while, and developers have it a little bit early. Now, if you're wondering if you should uninstall that beta profile if you're a developer or beta tester, I would wait until the public version is out, as sometimes there is an RC2 or a different version released to the public. So just keep that in mind, keep that beta profile installed. But now let's go ahead and take a look at the overall size, which is 5.31 gigabytes. That's on my iPhone 12 Pro Max and also on the iPhone 6S Plus, iPhone 11, as well as the iPad Pro. They were all over 5 gigabytes. Anytime you go from a beta version to a public version, it's going to be a huge install as it reinstalls just about everything. So that's pretty typical. It just overwrites the old operating system. It should not take up additional storage after it cleans everything up when it's done processing. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. Now I have iOS 15 RC on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, along with the iPhone 11 and iPhone 6S Plus. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 15 RC that I have on my iPad Pro 12.9 from 2021. Also along with that, they released tvOS 15 RC, as well as watchOS 8 RC, and they did not release macOS, but they did release HomePodOS 15 RC as well. So all of those updates are out now. And like I said before, we'll see the final fairly soon. Now, as far as the build number, we'll go to settings, then we'll go to general, then about. Now you can see the build number is 19A344. And this particular build should be the final version released to the public. It should have the same build number unless they find some last minute bugs. And we see an RC2 or changed at the final release. However, that's fairly rare with the major public releases. Now, as far as anything that's new, well, there is no new modem update in this version. If you're having cellular connectivity issues with 4G to 5G, I did not have a modem update since beta 7 on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. Maybe you'll see it on other devices, but I'm not seeing it anywhere as far as a modem update. However, it's been pretty good for me overall with this particular update. So hopefully it improves in some other code in the backend. As far as new features, well, the first thing I always get asked with the RC is there new wallpapers? So if we go to wallpaper and we go to choose a new wallpaper, if we go under live, you'll see that there is no new wallpaper whatsoever. So we don't have anything new as far as wallpaper and dynamic or anything like that. There's just no new wallpaper in this update. And the only wallpaper Apple showed today was with the announcement of the iPhone 13. So they'll have it on those devices. So if we go to Safari and go to the new iPhone, we'll go to iPhone here, and you'll see the new iPhone 13, 13 mini, 13 Pro, and iPhone 13 Pro Max with the new Sierra blue color and some new changes and updates. And I can talk about that in a different video. Let me know if you want me to talk about that in a separate video going over all of the things they announced today. But they showed some updates with this, with some new wallpaper, but those wallpapers are not in iOS 15 RC, and they'll typically only be on the iPhone 13. That's what Apple generally does, but someone will release them already if you haven't seen those already. Now, as far as new features and changes in this update, well, the first thing I noticed is when you open the App Store for the first time, you get a new splash screen. And while this isn't typically that exciting, one thing that is great is we now have Safari extensions on iOS. I was concerned they may not include this, but Safari is getting extensions not only on iPhone, but also iPad, just like it's had on the Mac for some time. So you can go to the App Store and search for those extensions, and you'll see all about them. You'll see standout Safari extensions. And if you go into that, it will give you some examples of extensions that you can bring into Safari and use. So there's other essentials with all of the different extensions and more. So you'll have those as well that you can look through, and these will be added to by the time it's released to the public. But we now have those Safari extensions. We did have the menu option in settings for it, but we just didn't have the option to actually do anything with them since they weren't available. In our Safari section, you'll see that we have extensions and you can manage them here. So it's ready to go. Extensions is good to go for this update. Now, as far as other changes, there is a slight change. It's very slight to the Apple Watch icon. This is because Apple updated the Apple Watch to an Apple Watch Series 7 today. So they made it slightly larger. It is not squared off like many of the rumors said. They made it slightly larger to match that with the icon. So that's been updated. Again, you can see that on Apple's website. And you can see the new Apple Watch Series 7. If we go back to watch, it doesn't look too much different, but it has a larger display and it's not squared off or anything. So it is a larger display. So they updated the icon to match that. Now, as far as other changes, well, there's some background code changes that my friend Steve Mosier helped me find, and that has to do with the new camera on the iPhone 13 series. They have a new cinematic mode that will be available for the 13 series phones where it can actually do what's called rack focus, where you focus between different objects. So maybe I have a person in the frame and they're in front of what's behind them. I can focus to the iPhone behind it. And then the other one goes out of focus. So kind of like I'm doing here, but you can pick the different objects you want into focus, such as the iPad back here or something along those lines. And you can also do it after the fact. So you've recorded it and then you can change the focus after. Those are on the Pro modeled phones. So some of those extensions and things that handle the camera are actually available. So within the camera before we could of course record video, but now we'll be able to choose focus after we've recorded it, which is something I'm very curious to see how it actually works. As far as anything else, well, they haven't changed a whole lot in the RC. However, there are a bunch of bug fixes. However, they have not mentioned any specific bug fixes. So if you were having issues with banking apps, I would expect those to get a bunch of updates in the App Store very soon, as well as other apps that aren't properly working with iOS 15 yet. We're starting to see app developers push out those updates to get those ready for iOS 15 when it launches on Monday. Now, as far as bugs and known issues, well, there are still quite a few remaining. There's 32 known issues still remaining, according to the notes. So there are some issues in this update, and that's pretty typical. No piece of software is ever perfect. So there will be additional issues with software and they will continue to fix it. When you create something new, you add different features, you'll always have other issues throughout. Hopefully this is a much more stable release than we've seen in the past with iOS 13 and iOS 14. Now, as far as iPadOS 15 RC, again, don't expect too many changes here other than the Safari extensions. So when you go into the App Store, again, it will give you that same splash screen that we're seeing before. So just talking about the App Store widget and those extensions, not a whole lot of other changes throughout the OS. And there may be some small changes here and there as they continue to refine things, but most of the features and changes are locked down for iOS 15. And then we'll see additional features in the future with future updates. Now, as far as overall performance should be pretty decent overall. On the iPhone 6S Plus, I would not expect a degradation in performance going from iOS 14 to 15. In fact, the only time I noticed it slowing down is when it first rebooted. And when they did first reboot, some of these phones had a hello screen on them. Some of them did not. So that's something that is a new feature that we've seen with iOS 15, but only the iPhone 12 Pro Max and the iPad had those features on them with the hello welcome screen. The older phones did not, but performance overall seems to be pretty good. The first boot up was a little bit choppy. You saw it was a little choppy just there on the 6S Plus here, and just scrolling through things like the app library in general are what you would have with iOS 14. There's really not any performance difference between the two. And that goes for the iPhone 11 or any other device. I know a lot of people are concerned about them being slowed down, but there's really no difference. In fact, you might even see it be a little bit faster with iOS 15 in general. So it seems to be okay overall. Now, as far as overall battery life, let's take a look at that. Battery life on iOS 15 RC will take a few days to measure completely to get an accurate picture of what it's like. And I typically do a follow-up on the weekend talking about that. So if you're concerned about battery life, be sure to check back. But after I updated this, I've been at 94% battery health since about beta 6 or so. The updates do not degrade the battery health. They're just rechecking it, but it's stayed pretty steady for me. And on beta 8, which is a little bit different than this. Now that we have debugging turned off and things, we should have some a better idea of what it's like. But yesterday I had 2 hours and 58 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 9 minutes of screen off time, but I used over 50% of my battery. Battery life has been very hit or miss in this update for me. Sometimes it's about 8 to 10 hours, other times it's not, but it really depends on what I'm doing. If I'm watching a lot of YouTube, of course it's going to go down more quickly, or if you're playing intensive games, or in bright light like this, where you have the brightness turned up to half, or even full if I'm recording outside. So it's really dependent on what I do. Where I recorded outside this past week, it used a lot of battery very quickly because you're pushing a lot of power to power that display. But most of the time it does pretty well, and people send me their battery all the time and they're getting 8 to 12 hours depending on their device. So it's pretty solid overall. Now, as far as the overall benchmarks, let's take a look at that. So we'll go into Geekbench here. I ran it on all of these devices, and for single core, I scored 1,587 on the iPhone 12 Pro Max and 4,119 for multi-core. That's actually a little bit better depending on which number we're looking at. It's a little bit better for multi-core and a little bit less for single core, but it's so close that it doesn't really make a difference, and I would expect very good performance. In fact, when I first started using this, I felt like it was much smoother than it was with Beta 8. Now let's take a look at all of these devices. Now from left to right, I have the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2021, followed by the iPhone 6S Plus, then the iPhone 11, and then the iPhone 12 Pro Max. And again, this should give you a general idea, and I ran these as soon as I updated, so they could improve a little bit after everything finishes in the background. Now, as far as if you should install this update, well, I would say absolutely if you're already on the beta. If you're waiting to try this out and you're on iOS 14.8 or an earlier version, this is probably going to be the final version released to the public, so it's pretty safe to try out at this point. I would just make sure you have a backup if you wanted to try that. But if you're already on one of the betas, definitely install it. It usually will fix quite a few things that you may have been having issues with, whether that be green tint or some other issues, although that seems to be more of a hardware issue in general. Now, as far as upcoming features with SharePlay, I would expect that with iOS 15.1 or maybe iOS 15.2. Apple has said it's coming later this fall, so it looks like it's still a feature they're pushing quite heavily, but they do need to actually add it back in, so it will take a little bit longer. So expect that a little bit later. And then this coming Monday, again, iOS 15 will release to the public. And then also, we have pre-orders going live for iPhone 13 and all of the different counterparts. Those pre-orders are going live on Friday the 17th at 8 a.m. Eastern time, with a release to the public on the 24th. So if you pre-order those, you can expect them on the 24th or a little bit later, depending on when you get your order in. So those are going live for iOS 13 or iPhone 13, with iOS 15 probably shipping on them as well. So that's it for everything with iOS 15 RC release candidate. And of course, like I said earlier, we'll see that final version released to the public on Monday, September 20th. So that's not too far away if you're waiting for that final version. So that'll be released to everyone that's on supported iOS 14 devices as well. Now, as far as anything else, well, we're waiting for iPhone 13, 13 mini, 13 Pro, 13 Pro Max, iPad, iPad Air, and then of course all of the other software that comes along with that. We'll probably see another event related to Macs a little bit later, but it was a bit of a surprise to see Apple announce all of the things they did today. So with Watch being released and all of those other things. So a lot that came out today, and of course with iOS 15 RC as well. Now, if you found anything else I failed to mention, please let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.